गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू रिज्यूम द टॉपिक विच वी हैव लेफ्ट बिहाइंड, अर्थ मैग्नेटिज्म एंड द मैग्नेटिक सब्सटेंसेस। एंड इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर स्टूडेंट, वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द एंगल ऑफ डिप, द एंगल मेड बाय द डिप मीडियम विद द हॉरिजॉन्टल फ्रॉम द सरफेस। वी कैन सी दैट पर्टिकुलर एंगल इज कॉल्ड एंगल ऑफ डिप। एंड वी हैव सीन द कंसेप्ट ऑफ magnetic north pole and magnetic south pole, and we have also seen that the where is the magnetic north and south. In magnetic north is in the northern hemisphere, and we have also defined the magnetic equator, and we have also seen the geographical equator, geographical north and geographical south. And now in the previous lecture we would define two terms, मैग्नेटिक मेरिडियन एंड ज्योग्राफिक मेरिडियन। सो व्हाट इज ज्योग्राफिक मेरिडियन? ज्योग्राफिक मेरिडियन, ज्योग्राफिक मेरिडियन स्टूडेंट्स आर अ प्लेन सरफेस। वी कैन से इट इज अ प्लेन सरफेस, इट इज अ प्लेन सरफेस पासिंग फ्रॉम या विच कंटेन्स, because it is geographic, so it contains geographical poles, means geographical north pole and geographical south pole. And in the surface of the earth, this is the earth, and this is, let's say, geographic north, and this is geographic south, and this is magnetic north, and this is magnetic south. Okay, so if you are anywhere on the surface, let's say you are here, wherever you are, from that point where you are and where you want to define the geographic meridian, you have to just imagine a plane surface which is passing from that point and which contains both north, geographic north and geographic south pole. That particular plane surface is called geographic meridian at that point. It's called geographic meridian at that point. So geographic meridian is simply a plane surface at a point of observation which contains geographic north and geographic south. So you can assume it could be like this. If you want to just understand, it could be, you can say this could be like this. This is the point of observation. The point of observation could also on the plane. It could also on the plane. And these two points, geographic north and geographic south, could also be on this plane, not on the boundary. It could be anywhere in the plane. It means we can take this plane also large. We could also take this plane like this, because these two points, this point, and if we can also further increase, this is like this. In this plane, all these three points are contained. But you can say, sir, this is also containing. If you just pass this point, if you pass this plane in such a way that only these two points, only these three points, means geographic north, geographic south, and the point of observation, could only be present in this particular plane, that plane is called geographical meridian. This is called geographical meridian. And in the same way, magnetic meridian at the same point of observation which contains magnetic north, magnetic south and passing from the same point. So we can say it could be like this. All these points could be on this plane, and that plane is called magnetic meridian. This is actually 3D problems, so you can just imagine that this plane could how oriented the particular scenario in the earth surface, so that it could contain north poles and south magnetic, south and the point of observation. And there is one more definition, angle of declination. Angle of declination alpha, it is the angle between, we can say, these two, geographical meridian and magnetic meridian. So it is the angle between these two planes. You can easily understood this concept by the help of a ball or a sphere, and you could locate north, geographic north and geographic south on that particular ball. You could locate magnetic north and magnetic south. Now you could imagine a plane at any point, or you could take any point on the surface of the particular ball which you have treated, you have assumed like a earth, and you can now see that a plane which is containing all the points, means geographic north, geographic south and the point of observation, that plane you can imagine perfectly when you take a ball as earth, and you could represent all this magnetic north and magnetic south and the point of observation, then you could be able to understand where is the your magnetic meridian plane, where is the your geographic meridian plane, and where is the angle of dip in that particular case. So do it in your homework, and understood particularly where is the plane passing and where is the angle of declination. So angle of declination is the angle between magnetic meridian and geographic meridian. And it is denoted as alpha, angle of declination. And the angle of declination value at different places on the surface of the earth is different, and because the position of geographic meridian and the magnetic meridian is also different at each places, they are differently aligned to each other, so the angle in between them is different for different places on the earth. Now we are going to start the topic magnetism in the materials or metals. Magnetism in materials. What is the cause of magnetism in the metals? We know that metals are made up of atoms. And in atoms, there are electrons which are revolving in an orbit, And we know that we have already studied this concept. If an electron is revolving in the orbit, there is a magnetic, it could be treated like a current carrying loop, because of if the electron is revolving like this, the current would be in the anti-clockwise because of that particular circular motion, the rotational circular motion of the electron. So if the electron is revolving in the circular, we can say in the orbit, so because of this motion, circular motion, there is a current in the, if the electron is moving anti-clockwise, there is a current in clockwise direction. So that is treated like a current carrying loop. And we know that the current carrying loop is just like a bar magnet. There is a we can say magnetic dipole moment because of that current carrying loop. And the direction of the magnetic dipole moment, which is M vector, represented by M vector, which is I A vector, and the direction of the magnetic dipole moment is from south pole to north pole. From south pole to north pole, we have told this concept in the previous lecture, south pole to north pole. And we could also find the direction by the right hand rule. And if we place our hand in the direction, we could close our finger in the direction of the current. If electron is revolving here, so the current would be like, current would be in this direction. If electron is moving here, so the current is in this direction, means clockwise. And if we place our hand like this, this in the direction of the current, our fingers are closing in the direction of the current, our thumb is in towards the inward, it means south to north. So where is the south? South is here and the north is inside this. So we can say it is magnetic dipole, and it could be represented by the this sign representing. So that particular electron is like a current carrying loop, and that is producing a magnetic dipole moment of itself. But there is, we can say in an atom there is more number of electrons, there are some other electrons, and all the electrons contributing the magnetic dipole moment of itself. So the net magnetic dipole moment, because of all the electrons present in the we can say a particular atom of an element, could be zero also, it could be zero or it could be non-zero. And if it could be zero, it means that particular material, the net magnetic moment because of that particular atom of the particular element is zero. So there is no net dipole moment, and they are very weak, we can say very weak, showing very weak magnetic properties, and that are called diamagnetic materials. It are called diamagnetic materials. Diamagnetic materials. But in some element, the atoms of the element have net dipole moment. So we are taking that particular materials for understanding purposes. So that materials are called paramagnetic, and we can also, there are other elements, ferromagnetic materials, paramagnetic and ferromagnetic materials. In paramagnetic and ferromagnetic, there is a net dipole moment because of a single atom, not because of a whole of the material. I am not talking about the whole of the material. If we take an iron piece, so in the iron piece there are infinite, we can say there are more number of atoms present, but we are just considering right now a single atom, and because of a single atom there is a net dipole moment in paramagnetic and ferromagnetic. Now what about overall, now what about the a piece of material, let's say this is a piece of material of either paramagnetic or ferromagnetic. So all the atoms are, we know that all there is a magnetic dipole moment, so we are representing the atom like this, like dipoles, magnetic dipoles, and they are in randomly direction aligned. They are aligned in a random direction, and because of this arrangement, the net dipole moment, because of this random alignment of the magnetic dipole moment of all the atoms of paramagnetic or ferromagnetic, we can say the net dipole moment of a material is zero. The net dipole moment is zero, but there is an individual dipole moment. As we have seen in case of current electricity, the charge, electron free electrons in the conductor are individually contributing a current because they are moving in random direction. But the current, because of all the overall whole material, is zero, because contribution of all the electrons, current contribution of, because of all the electrons are cancelling out each other. But when we place a external cell and we place a, we can say, battery, we connect a battery, then there is an external field, and because of that field the electrons could start moving in a particular direction, and then there is a net current because of that particular cell, battery, external source. In the same way, there is no net magnetic dipole moment. The net magnetic dipole moment you are seeing here, zero, they are in balance situation, they are no magnetic dipole moment. And when magnetic field is applied, and when there is a magnetic field, we can say there is a uniform magnetic field, external, B external, and a material, para or ferromagnetic material we are talking about, is placed in the particular magnetic field. As we have seen in the electrostatic, when an electric dipole is placed in a uniform electric field, there is a torque, and because of that torque, the particular dipole could start to align itself in the direction of the electric field. In the same way here, these dipoles which are in the random direction, they could now start aligning in the direction of this magnetic, external magnetic field. Okay. We can see here the dipoles are trying to align in the direction of the external magnetic field, and as we know that the magnetization, magnetic dipole moment, not magnetization, this is the magnetic dipole moment, the magnetic dipole moment, the direction of the magnetic dipole moment, and is south to north, and we can say, if we know that this is north pole, this is south pole, and the direction of M is towards south to north, and we know that the magnetic field is like this in the bar magnet, north to south, and inside south to north. So it means the direction of the magnetic dipole moment tells the direction of the magnetic field. So it means all the magnetic dipole moments are aligned in this. It means there is a net field. There is a, because of this magnetization, now this material is start magnetizing. This is starting magnetizing, and this is magnetizing because of this external magnetic field. When there is no magnetic field, the net magnetic dipole moment is zero. There is no net magnetic field. But as we place this magnetic material in the external magnetic field, all the dipoles start aligning in the direction, because there is a torque. There is a torque on the magnetic dipole, and the torque start aligning the magnetic dipole in the external field direction, and because of this, B external, and there is a field because of dipole itself. So it means the magnetic field inside this magnetic material is because of this dipole, there is because of the net magnetic dipole moment, that the net magnetic dipole moment, and because of external, B external. Now the net magnetic field inside this magnetic material is because of B external and because of net dipole, magnetic dipole moment. because now the net magnetic dipole moment is not zero. It means there is magnetic field of this material itself. And this is also in here, it means the net magnetic field here is increased. So the net, this is very important point, the net magnetic field, inside a magnetized, magnetic material is greater than the external magnetic field. It is greater than the external magnetic field. Now, one more important thing here, students, is the magnetic dipole moment is only because of a revolution of an electron. This is also because of we know that electron also rotate on its axis, rotational motion on its axis itself. Beside circular motion, electrons also rotate on its axis itself. It means there is some contribution of dipole moment because of its spin, circular spin, angular momentum, but that contribution is very small compared to this. And because of nucleus, there is also the magnetic dipole moment, but the effect of magnetic dipole moment because of the nucleus and because of the spin angular momentum of the electron on its axis very small as compared to this one. So we could neglect that effect. So we are only considering the magnetic dipole moment because of the circular motion of the electron in its orbit. Okay. So this is the cause how the magnetism is in the material. It is because of the circular motion of the electron, because of the dipole moment creation, because of a net dipole moment of an atom, and finally when we place a magnetic material in the external magnetic field, uniform magnetic field, there is a torque on the magnetic dipole, and it also start aligning in the direction of the magnetic field. Then the net magnetic field inside the material is greater than the external magnetic field, because it is the sum of magnetic field itself and the sum of B external, which is in the same direction. So it is greater than the external magnetic field. This is the reason we place we can say soft iron in case of solenoid, and we wrap a insulated wire on the solenoid on a soft iron core. So that is the reason that we could increase the magnetic field in the solenoid, we can say in a structure like solenoid. Now this phenomenon, we have seen that as we place a magnetic material in the external magnetic field, there is a net magnetic dipole moment induced in the magnetic material. This phenomenon is called magnetic induction. So magnetic induction is what? Inducing net magnetic dipole moment and net magnetic field inside the magnetic material. When we place a magnetic material in an external magnetic field, that is called magnetic induction. And this B, this vector B, which you say that it is magnetic field, it is actually magnetic flux density. And magnetic flux density is B equal to phi B, means magnetic flux. Phi B is magnetic flux and area. के वेक्टर। तो हियर वी कैन से phi इक्वल टू b डॉट a। एज वी डिफाइन phi e डॉट a, यू हैव सीन, यू हैव स्टडी इन द इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक। सो phi इक्वल टू b डॉट a, यू कैन से इट इज b a cos थीटा phi e, एंड थीटा इज 90 डिग्री। सो थीटा इज एंगल बिटवीन b एंड a, एंगल बिटवीन b एंड a, एंगल बिटवीन b एंड a, एंगल बिटवीन b एंड a इज द प्लेन एरिया वेक्टर, प्लेन सरफेस एरिया वेक्टर, बिकॉज एरिया वेक्टर इज डिफाइंड फॉर द प्लेन सरफेस, एंड इट इज b a, सिंपली b a व्हेन थीटा इज when theta is 0, not 90, when theta is 0 degree, it is cos 0 and cos 0 is 1. So we can say b equal to phi b by a. And from here we could define the definition of this magnetic flux density. It is the number of magnetic field lines. It is the number of magnetic field lines, because it is a number, it is a scalar quantity. It is the b dot a. So it is the number of, it is the number of magnetic field lines passing through the unit area normally, passing through the unit area normally, because when we take normally word, this is very important here, because when we take normally, it means angle between B and the area vector is zero. So that's why we are saying this, that the magnetic flux density at a particular place is the number of magnetic field lines passing through a unit plane area normally is called magnetic flux density. And the unit is, the magnetic flux unit is Weber, and this is meter square. So this is meter per Weber per meter square, and it is also called Tesla. So this is the first definition, magnetic flux density B. Now the second is intensity of magnetization. And it is denoted by I vector. It is what? Intensity of magnetization I vector equal to M vector upon V. What is M vector? Net magnetic dipole. It is net magnetic dipole moment, net magnetic dipole moment upon volume. So if volume is 1, we can say I equal to M net. If V equal to 1 meter cubic in a SI system, I vector equal to M net. Means we have seen that when we place a magnetic material in the external magnetic field, they are aligned in the direction of the external magnetic field. And now we can, if you take a unit volume inside this material, unit volume means 1 meter cubic, or we can say 1 centimeter cubic, we can take unit volume, and if we see that there is a net magnetic moment. Now the net magnetic moment is not zero, because it is placed in the external magnetic field, and this magnetic, net magnetic moment per unit volume is defined as intensity of magnetization. This is called intensity of magnetization. And the unit is, we can say, we know that M is I and a vector. So it is I a by b m, and it is I a by b, and it is ampere, meter square meter cancel, this is ampere per meter, ampere meter inverse, and the dimensional formula is a l minus 1. This is a l minus 1. Now the second is intensity of magnetic field, intensity of magnetic field और इंटेंसिटी ऑफ मैग्नेटाइजिंग फील्ड बोथ आर सेम इंटेंसिटी ऑफ मैग्नेटाइजिंग फील्ड एच वेक्टर इंटेंसिटी ऑफ मैग्नेटाइजिंग फील्ड एच वेक्टर we have seen that this is related to external magnetic field intensity of the external field magnetic field by which the magnetic material magnetized so this is related to intensity of the external magnetic field and we have seen that if we increase the external magnetic field intensity the intensity of the magnetization means the net magnetic dipole moment also increases means I increases and if I increases we can say the net magnetic field inside the magnetic material this is the magnetic material and when we place a magnetic field external when we place this magnetic material in the external magnetic field this there is a net magnetic dipole moment introduced in the magnetic material and the net field of this is increased as we have already told you the net field of this material is increased because it is the sum of B external and the magnetic field of this material itself because of the net magnetic dipole moment introduced in the material itself so we can say B net is in this material B net is proportional to the intensity of the magnetizing field and the intensity of the magnetization which is being happened in the material and H is intensity of that field which is magnetizing this material so this is H plus I because both are same this is external this is internal we can say this is internal intensity so sorry this is external intensity of the magnetic field this is internal and because of these two the net field net induction is increased net magnetic field will be increased so this is proportional to H and I so we can say B equal to proportionality mu naught H plus I from here H equal to B by mu naught minus I in divide minus so H equal to B by mu naught into I so H is what intensity of the magnetizing field which is magnetizing this material and I is what intensity of the magnetization means of this magnetic material how strongly it is being magnetized this is the measure of by the I how strongly this material is being magnetized this is measured by I and how strong the magnetic field which is magnetizing this material is measured by H I think you have figured this point here now we are going to define and we have also seen here I this I means intensity of magnetization means internal intensity is proportional to H external intensity it is depending on H if we increase H intensity of external field intensity of internal field also increases so we can say this depending on this and on placing the equality there is a constant Xm and what is Xm susceptibility and susceptibility we can define Xm of the magnetic material is I by H Xm is defined as I by H it is the ratio of intensity of magnetization to the intensity of magnetizing field and both are same unit both are same dimension the dimension of and unit of I and H are same both are same thing that's why we are writing here intensity outside intensity inside इंटेंसिटी ऑफ मैग्नेटाइजिंग मटेरियल, इंटेंसिटी ऑफ मैग्नेटाइजिंग फील्ड। ओके, तो दिस इज ससेप्टिबिलिटी, इट इज अ यूनिटलेस क्वांटिटी बिकॉज बोथ आर सेम थिंग, सो इट इज अ रेशियो, सो वी कैन डिफाइन दिस डेफिनेशन इन विद द रेशियो ऑफ इंटेंसिटी ऑफ मैग्नेटाइजिंग टू द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ द मैग्नेटाइजिंग फील्ड। नाउ फ्रॉम हियर वी कुड पुट I equal to x m h here, so here B equal to mu naught h plus x m h, take h common, it is mu naught 1 plus x m and h. And what is this? We know that mu is what? Permeability of medium, magnetic material, permeability of magnetic material. And it is defined as, mu is defined as B, magnetic flux density, and magnetic field intensity. It is defined as the ratio of magnetic field, magnetic flux density to the ratio of magnetic field intensity. So mu is defined as the ratio of magnetic flux density and magnetic field intensity. So from here we could compare these two things, B equal to mu h. So we can say mu equal to mu naught 1 plus xm. This is the formula, this is the relation between mu and mu naught and xm. And we can also see that this is, we have defined mu equal to, we know that it is mu equal to mu naught into mu r. So from here mu equal to mu naught mu r, so we can say in place of mu r we have 1 plus xm, so mu r equal to 1 plus xm. So this is the relation between relative permeability and susceptibility. So we can also say that xm equal to mu r minus 1. It means you can see it is negative for diamagnetic, because for diamagnetic mu r is less than 1. So it is negative for diamagnetic material. So these are all the terms related to today's video lecture. And in the last part we would define just the hysteresis curve, and this chapter could be finally closed, and we would next start the alternating current chapter, alternating AC chapter.